Now this is a very rare strain of the T-virus. It produces mRNA, the most destructive strain of the T-virus we know so far.
Professor, how long have you been studying the T-virus?
Oh, I'm not the professor. I'm here with the tour guy. But I did subscribe to the Sparkman channel last night. You should do it too. Like the video and subscribe.
Hello there and welcome to another video. My name is Sparkman.
I'm a game developer.
I develop games for Android and iOS and other stuff. Windows/HTML5, blah blah blah. I was watching a trailer for Finding Dory. And so I put together a small game very quickly.
About 10 minutes.
So let me show you this. Get here something that looks like Marlin or Nemo. It's hard to tell when the characters are so pixelated. I'm gonna go for his Nemo. Trying to find Dory.
Alright, so let me show you this demo.
And, basically...
You have to collect the coins. Okay, I get it, it's like Flappy Bird.
Alright, so let's open the example file, which you will find under the description below. And you can see that this is just a background. And, these corals are actually just pictures. Here's the coin, if you double click on it, you can see that it's animated. Let's double click on Nemo. I should probably label him Nemo. Nemo trying to find Dory. I'm going to double click on the fish.
Nemo.
You can see that it's 4 frames. I did this in Photoshop in a couple of minutes. All right, let's open the example file. If you don't know what software I'm using, there is a link down below. If you run it, you notice that nothing happens.
You can move Nemo, but nothing happens.
And the reason you can move the fish is because he is a direction object. Let's take this...
two corals,
and let's transform those into bouncing ball. I'm going to set the speed to 10, and the initial direction is going to be left, straight out. You can see that they move right away. Make the coin bouncing ball as well. Speed 10, initial direction left, straight out. You can see that the coin moves as well. I'm going to insert a new object,
a new counter.
Now this doesn't need to be visible, and let's go to the event editor. Here's the event editor, and every millisecond we want to add one to this counter.
Add one to counter
straight out. You can see that the counter goes up. So when the counter reaches 100, we set it back to 0 straight out, and now we have a loop. Counter reaches 100, we want to create one of these corals at this position. Okay, you can see that that works not too bad. Maybe we should create the corals a little slower. Try
3 milliseconds.
And that seems more reasonable. Now you notice that the corals have different heights. Sometimes they come low and sometimes they... Let me show you why. Here is the object we're generating the objects from. And if you went to properties, you can see that this is a path object. The path it follows, loops at the end. Actually, I'm going to place this here so you can see what's happening. You can see that it moves back and forth. And it generates one of the corals when the counter reaches 100. The different heights. Now we don't have to have this visible. Place it back here somewhere.
Go to the event editor.
And let's create the one for the top. At the same position. But this time we're going to raise this a little higher. Straight out. Not too bad there. And it's sort of like Flappy Bird,
except for you can move the fish.
Let's do the coins. Here's the coin. And we're gonna place the coins at the exact same spot. Except for we're gonna drag them up somewhere in between the two corals. Straight out.
Here's the first coin.
And that's not too bad there. Now you can see that all we need now is a collision for the coin. Now if the fish collides with the coin,
we destroy
the coin. And we can probably add a sound to this. Straight out. Now we can move this counter out of the way. It doesn't need to be visible. If you notice, I have a another object here. This is just a picture. The corals collide with that. Collide with the blue object. We destroy the first coral. It's the second one.
Collides with the blue object. We destroy it as well.
And if we if the fish collides with the any of these corals, then we can simply restart the frame.
change it for the other coral.
Let's try it out.
If you collide with this, you restart the game.
Alright, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, like the video, and I will see you in the next episode.